I made people laugh and smile in that shopping centre yesterday. I was creative. I created a buzz around my photography stand. And if I could have had my orders delivered, I'd have made you a fortune yesterday. I'd have made you an absolute fortune.
But you didn't. You know, it's almost insulting me in saying, yeah, I did. I drummed up a lot of business. The only thing is I screwed everything else up.
Simon, if I asked you to build me a wall, you'd build me a wall. I'm pretty sure of it. If I asked you to dig me a trench, I think you'd dig me a trench. I am not that sure that if I gave you my investment portfolio, you'd be able to run that very well. I'm sorry, my friend. I think you're a bit out of your depth here. And with regret, you're fired.
Thank you for a wonderful opportunity.
Okay.
Simon, the likeable fellow. Pain in the ass, but a likeable fellow. To run one of my businesses, no way. He's just totally and absolutely out of his depth.
I give it my best shot. I give it everything I had. I gave 100% in every task I did. I made a lot of people smile in that shopping centre yesterday, and that was a really good feeling. But at the end of the day, I failed. And I'll go home now, pick myself up, and I'll be putting satellite dishes up again next week.
Week 5. Off to the countryside to turn a raw material into a product. Sir Alan wanted dairy ice cream, sold in bulk, but with brand new flavours.
Ginseng and ginger.
Oh, I like ginseng's that. An aphrodisiac.
Yes. Goji berries, wheatgrass.
Yeah. What about, like, a normal cup of tea?
The basic principle of this task was all about finding some new customers for a very, very small cottage industry. These small farmers needed to find a new business, a new outlet.
That is delicious. Oh, do you know what I smelt then? Perfection.
The customers that they were going to get for these farms were actually going to be meaningful to the actual farmers themselves.
On the losing team, business liaison manager Lindy Mgaza.
We've got three different flavours of ice cream. Has everybody got a spoon?
Yeah.
My nickname is African Princess, because I'm from royal descendants in South Africa. So I think, you know, I'm born to be royalty, I'm born to be a winner, I'm born to be a leader, I'm born to be looked at and people say, wow.
We are sizzling hot.
Do you know
superstars.
What, I'm just...
We're absolutely amazing. It just doesn't get any better.
Luxury. Charged with finding customers, Lindy pointed the sales team in the wrong direction.
Well, the fact is, we make our own ice cream.
A couple of things I'd like to check with you.
Some of our equipment has no need for ice cream.
They have their own ice cream maker.
Do you know what, Lucinda?
Can I just tell you from experience?
Yes. Even if they've got their own ice cream maker, we can still sell to them.
Of course, you're the sales team, you know.
But if they're not going to take it, they're not going
to
take it.
See you. Thanks, bye.
Just find it annoying when people tell you how to do things that you know how to do.
She finally condemned herself with an off-the-cuff guarantee to a chain of gastro pubs.
Is there an opportunity for you to agree that it won't go into any other pubs for at least 3 months?
We can put that as a condition on the order, that we'll guarantee you exclusivity for 3 months.
OK.
Most definitely. 3 months exclusivity.
Crazy. A crazy thing to do.
Oh, that was nice and easy.
It showed me a kind of desperation where you gave away the shop. And anybody who gives away the shop, from as far as Sal's point of view is concerned, is useless to me.
You had no right offering any exclusivity whatsoever. You're out representing a farmer who's trying to build up a business in London. And here you are giving away his total opportunity now of selling.
I didn't give it away. The gentleman asked for it.
Because he asked for it doesn't mean he can have it. Sometimes you have to turn a deal down, you know. Did you cancel any other appointments afterwards once you granted exclusivity? So yeah, there you go. You've even done it yourself. You've demonstrated to yourself how you have limited the farmer's business.
Lindy takes great pleasure in telling how great she is and how wonderful she is and what she's achieved in the past, blah, blah, blah. But I couldn't see her achieving anything for me.
Lindy, you were second in command for what I think was the most important part in this task. The selling of the merchandise. And it's Sal's that you lost this task on. And that brings me to a conclusion that, Lindy, you're fired.
I am probably still in a state of shock
as to why he hasn't understood how special I am, but he must have missed that point.
Week 6, bank manager Kevin Shaw ran out of credit.
By the age of 20, I had my first house. By the age of 23, I had my second house. By the age of 23, I had my Porsche. Now I want a Ferrari. I've got 1 year to get it, and I'll do anything I can to be the most successful businessman the world has seen by the age of 40.
You're looking at the kitchen staff. Okay. The head chef is Kevin.
Right. 2 weeks earlier, his ego had taken a battering when he cast himself as the boy's Italian chef.
OK, I was thinking spaghetti bolognese, really straightforward. I can get a batch of bolognese sauce.
How's the food today?
It's just tasteless. It needs to be seasoned. Salt and pepper.
Was there an issue with your spaghetti bolognese?
It wasn't very nice.
It wasn't very nice. No. This is how it is. I've just had to give away 2 main meals because the customers are absolutely disgusted with the food that's actually gone out there.
But he needs to listen.
Kev, shut up and listen to me, yeah?
Creating a new range of greeting cards finished him off. Converted to green evangelism by Jenny Solerier.
We're getting sort of a huge environmental awareness that's growing in the UK, yeah. And it's all about your commitment to lowering your carbon emissions.
Some of these supermarkets, they're paying you now to recycle your bags and things, aren't they? So they're obviously quite aware of that themselves.
Yeah,
Kevin got confused. Yes, it's highly topical. Yes, it's on the agenda of everybody worrying about the future of the planet and this, that and the other. The only thing is, it is not the topic of a greeting card. And that's where he made his fatal error, and it was all downhill from there.
When it came to pitching Love Your Planet Week, Kevin failed to call on Claire's experience.
The question to you is, do you feel that you could go in there and just smash it to pieces and you are the person that they'd want to buy from?
Yeah, definitely. This, for me, it's quite normal.
Now, Claire, she is a retail buyer. She has people coming in trying to sell her things all day long. What she's forgotten about bullshit in pitching things, he hasn't even learnt yet.
I'm totally 150% confident that I can go in there and nail a pitch. I know I can do that.
Why he didn't choose her to do it, I do not know.
Pleased to meet you. My name's Kevin Shaw.
Pleased to meet you.
434 million tonnes worth of rubbish is thrown away each year.
He was like a lecturer. I could see that the retailers were, in some cases, angered by him.
If you don't put your weight behind it, then it's just the same as the US saying, we don't care about pollution.
Would you not consider it a contradiction in terms that somebody who is eco-friendly would want to pay for a card when potentially they could send an e-card?
No, I don't believe they would, because I think the whole point of this card is we're trying to educate people.
He'd forgotten that what he was offering was commercial product for them to resell. Forget the sentiment of it, forget that we all want a green world. These are hardcore businesses that want to buy something for £1 and sell it for £2. Two of these retailers that specialise in greeting cards thought your idea was appalling. They found you a bit cocky. They found you preaching to them. Not selling them cards, preaching to them. There was a smell of arrogance about you, they felt. He got waylaid by Jenny. She forced that task on him. She kind of seduced him in a way, and he let her go.
Why is Jenny not in this room?
I've got no idea. It was Kevin.
Jenny, you know, from start to finish, worked very hard. She was very creative.
On a poor idea. Well, very hard she railroaded you into doing
she
this.
She didn't railroad
well,
me.
Well, she must.
I couldn't
she did. I think she ran this no. bloody task.
No, she didn't, Sir Alan, because I had complete control of my team.
He was too full of himself. He got waylaid by Jenny. It wasn't his idea. That's why he had to go.
Kevin, this whole task turned out a fiasco. And as team leader, I hold you totally responsible. Kevin, you're fired.